Hey, cleaner.
Hey, what's up, bro?
Once again, we are here again. Yeah, 66 speed bike, looking for the cleaner.
Okay.
Have you seen the cleaner? Dah habis sapu?
No, still have a lot of cleaning.
Okay.
Yeah, tell me.
So today, again, 66 speed bike. Here we are. And we have the legend, the cleaner.
No, I'm not legend.
Cleaning all the corners everywhere in Malaysia.
No.
How come you weren't in that Harian Metro video, ah?
Oh,
that would be nice lah.
The
guy took some shitty videos. Better he take you go a nice siku corner.
Itulah.
Right. Instead of people tengah santai-santai, kena blame as speeding.
Betul lah. Kesian mamat yang ambil. Lagi-lagi yang BM biru tu. Look like my brother, you know. I thought it was my brother, but it was not him.
Okay, so straight to the point. Let's go. It's gonna be Tech Talk again series, and today we want to talk about magnet coil. Or is it called a rectifier? No, right?
No, different thing. Magnet coil is different than rectifier.
Okay, so magnet coil, can you tell us what is the function of magnet coil?
So all the new bikes nowadays, if you see the new bikes, they require ECU. So what is this ECU? It's basically electronic control unit. So this ECU is sending pulses, is sending electronic signal to our sensors, to our engine, for it to basically start. So this ECU get the electric current from the battery. Without the battery, without the battery, this ECU cannot be used. So for that, we need a good battery to basically supplying the power to the ECU. But however, this battery, if you use it for some time, the voltage inside the battery will get depleted, right? It will go down. A normal working battery voltage is going to be around 13.6 to 14.4 volt. That is what you will see on the bike as it is running. However, when the battery get below 11 volt, it will send a signal to cut down, the ECU will sense a low voltage on the battery, and it will cut down the signal to the sensor. And most of the time, if you see that you are running 10.5, I think the electronic will cut down the engine. This is kind of a safety things that you will have on the ECU. So how we recharge this battery as is it running? Okay, the old days, maybe, I don't know, the old days, what they will do, they will take the battery, they will charge. Once the battery is charged, they will put back in the motor, and then you can use the motorbike, right? But this will take a lot of effort. So there should be a way where we can recharge the bike or the battery as we are using the bike. So there, at that moment, is come this magnet coil. Some people call it magnet coil, some people call it as a stator. Car, I think they call it as an alternator. Or generator or whatever. So what is this coil is doing? It's basically generating voltage that can recharge your battery to the operating voltage. So most of the time you will see the new generation of magnet coil is basically wet type. The old days, you will see some of it is basically a dry type. How it works? If basically this magnet coil is located in your magnet area of your engine. So when your engine are turning or the magnet are turning around this coil, so what this does is basically creating polar sheet, I don't know what the name.
Magnetic fields. Basically, or some electrical current thing.
Current generated lah.
Okay, yes.
So when this magnet is moving around this stator, right? So what it does, it create a voltage. But the voltage, it create the current. So the current is basically, is AC type, right? It's non-DC, it's AC. Because of it, the bike required DC. At that moment, we are using the rectifier to change the AC voltage to a DC voltage. That's where the rectifier works. But the main part of our engine is basically the starter, or we call it as a magnet coil. Without this, we can't recharge our battery, and we can't use our motorbike.
Okay, so I guess that's the function of this stator or magnet coil.
You have to cut it, like, I've talked many shit.
Yeah, you always talk too much, but it's fine. Then, okay, so can you tell us, like, how does the magnet coil get burned? Or what are the reasons it get burned?
A lot of things can cause it, right? One is factory default, right? It depends. Whoever make the coil, they use a different material, or we call it as this wire, right? Bronze wire, this one. So whatever company that using it, they have different type of material, right? The company that coil it as well is another factor. The isolator, if you see that inside this coil, it has isolator, right? How thick is the insulator is also another factor that contribute to a burning coil.
Will changing different engine oils all the time affect?
It does, because how it get burned is because of heat.
Okay.
Okay, to burn this heat, basically you have to heat it up to a certain degree where at that moment it will get burned, right?
So the thing that cools it down is the engine oil.
Engine oil. That's why we use a wet type. Because this thing, when it's working, right, it's constantly sending current to our rectifier or to our battery.
So it's
at that moment,
hot.
It's freaking hot. It's, okay. It is really hot at that moment. Okay. So when it's hot, the only way to cool it down is basically using your engine oil. If you do a test, you start your bike, you touch the wire, you can feel that it's really hot, the wire is really hot. Of course, if some of our viewers want to do a test, what they can do is they can go to an electric pole and try to touch the wire and see if it's hot or not.
Okay guys, don't do that, okay? We are not liable for any death.
Don't do that. Okay, you're basically gonna kill yourself.
Yeah. Okay, right. So
To prevent it from getting burned is basically to make it sure that it's cooled down at all time. A low viscosity oil most of the time will cause high temperature in the engine.
Okay.
You should use higher weight, which is most of the time is much cooler.
So you mean what, the thicker oil?
The thicker oil, yeah.
So if people are running on fully synthetic, they are always usually thinner oil, right?
Most of the time is thinner oil.
So is it gonna hurt the...
Most of the time it doesn't hurt. But the thing is, oil is one thing. The most time that you will see that it get to your stator is because of your battery. When you use your battery more than 2 years, what happened, the battery doesn't really have the ability to keep the voltage inside it, right?
Okay.
So the initial voltage is already low. So as you're running the engine, the initial is low, so the stator has to send more or had to work harder to send or to recharge the battery. Due to this, it get hit up higher.
So you're saying that the battery actually affects the coil to burn, this magnet coil to burn. But this battery is cheaper than the coil, right? So it's better to change the battery instead of burning
I always recommend a customer to change a battery 2 years and less. Don't exceed more than 2 years. Engine oil, proper maintenance of your engine oil. Make sure that you use a certified engine oil.
Okay.
Make sure you don't, you have a way to check your level of your engine oil. Make sure that you have enough or sufficient engine oil before you start your engine as well. Because if you are running a low engine oil inside your engine, of course, you don't have enough fluid or engine oil to lubricate the starter.
So from what you're saying, the common cause will be the weak battery that will cause it to burn, and then the oil.
Engine oil, of course.
The incorrect amount or the type of oil.
Or electrical as well, sometimes.
Okay.
Electrical.
So, the next part is that once you have burned the coil, what are your options? How do you fix
get
this problem?
Get a new
one. So,
get a new one. Kawasaki. Tell my customer to get a new one.
Kawasaki says
get a new one. Oh, sorry. It's not Kawasaki. It's the third. But it's like Kawasaki, whatever.
What, you mean this? This is Kawasaki original, okay?
Holy shit, man, it get burned.
But, yeah, but
Kawasaki
still
have a lot of problem with this.
Really?
Okay, come on.
So, okay, so apart from changing a new one, which is like cost a bomb, yes. I think it's like
there is
800 to 1,000 ringgit for one.
You can do a recoiling, or we call it as a rewinding.
Okay.
You rewind the coil. Mm-hmm. But the things that you have to make sure is you get a guy that know what is the thickness of your wire, copper wire. If you use the wrong copper wire, then the voltage will be different.
Okay.
And he has to know as well how many loop that he need to do on the first, second and third layer, or whatever, fourth layer or whatever.
So recoiling is not something that I can just go to the hardware store, buy copper and just do it myself.
You can do.
Without any knowledge.
You can do, but probably you're gonna burn out.
Like ikut suka hati I ni lah.
You're gonna burn out your bike lah, so it's either way lah.
Okay, so I'm just gonna burn it again. Then I just recoil again. So how many times can we recoil? So I keep on burning it, I can recoil forever lah.
Not really. Because once your insulator is already burned out totally, at that moment you will have direct contact of your wire to the body. If you have a direct contact to the body, it's either to get a new insulator or get a new coil. Maximum I see people do like 2 or 3 times only.
To recoil it 2 or 3 times.
Yeah.
But then if the thing is keep on frequently burning, there should be something else that's going on, right?
That's probably your grounding is fucked up. You have to check. It's basically, it's all related to your electrical system. So charging a battery is not only a charging. You have to know if it really properly grounded to your body. You have to know as well if it really the charging wires are correct. You know, there is no, discharge from your wiring to the body, you know. Your rectifier, you have to check your rectifier as well. Is it COM or radio or still can be used? So a lot of things can need to be checked, honestly.
Okay, I think that's about it for today. I see there's a lot of trash you need to clean up.
Oh,
and
yeah,
also
man.
The toilet stinks.
Oh shit.
So please go ahead and do your shit.
Who the heck came over? Shit,
I think it's that botak fella, I don't know which one.
Oh, sambal.
Okay. Alright, so
right, thank you very much.
Once again, 66 speed bike, thank you. Ahmad Khan. Go and sweep.